to tonight's game between the Creighton Bloejays and the Northwestern Wildcats. And before we go any further, let's check in on our Star Watch, Dick. And of course, here's our starting lineup.
My oh my, take a look at what we have here. Two solid big men matched up with one another at the five spot. It's always great to watch a couple of talented bigs down low.
And it's time for the tip-off. Early in the ball game, these two teams trying to set their particular tempo. They work it around the perimeter. Number 44 is charged with the foul. First team foul. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
Here's another solid junior, Dick.
Hey, I tell you, juniors and seniors are valuable pieces in any college basketball puzzle. Having experienced kids like this on the court and on the bench can take a lot of pressure off the coaching staff.
It's his second. They've got him trapped here, Dick.
Look at that trap, Brad.
So Dick's so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior. And they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
On the outside. Pull-up jumper, left side. The missed shot. Gets it to go. They move it into the front court.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Knocked away. Great block. Oh, he dribbled the ball out of bounds. The offense begins off the sideline inbounds. Let's watch the move as he works his man and out a fadeaway jumper. Our three-prong attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brad Nessler with Dick Vitale and our friend EA Aaron Andrews checking in from the sideline.
Trying to go inside.
They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
The Wildcats here running their zone offense.
Boy, I'll tell you what, Brad. The zone motion offense creates a lot of opportunities if you get ball movement and player movement. If you get people to step into the gaps in the zone and reverse the ball, you'll get good shots.
Refs call the foul the other way.
That's how you take a charge, baby.
Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad, bad foul right there, Brad.
The Blue Jays now running a zone offense.
Well, the key to zone motion offense is you got to get good ball movement. If you get good ball movement to get the zone to really slide and use the skip pass to make it tough for that zone to adjust. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
There they come with a double team to stop it. That one finds its way out of bounds, but we'll keep it right here. Running that Princeton offense here.
I'll tell you, that Princeton offense drives you bananas. Look at the way they spread the court. Tremendous spacing, great execution, and they read so exceptionally well. Any mistake the defense makes, it is absolutely layup time.
Cross court. And up, busts the jumper. Zone offense now. Cross court.
I love that block shot, Brad. Really gives you a lot of momentum.
Can't get the shot to drop. They work it around the perimeter. Goes up for two. Off the glass, and there's a nice block from behind, Dick.
Yeah, that's good timing for the defense. Look at that spacing.
He shoots from the deep corner and off the mark. Drains the shot. The Blue Jays are getting some great opportunities to score when they get the ball in the high post.
They got the ball into the high post, and the defense couldn't react on time, Brad.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
There's a double team waiting there. Number 44 with the foul. Second personal foul. Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits the foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket. You know, seniors are important because they bring so much to the team. Leadership, motivation, and a sense of accountability. It's their last year, so you know they want to make it a memorable one.
It goes in. Traps in place, Dick. Pushes it up. Zone motion now. Cross court. In the lane. They get it to go. Cross court. He puts up the J. Nails a sweet jumper. He can put points up and he can move the ball.
It doesn't matter if you're a scorer who passes well or a good passer who can score. There will always be a spot for you on a team.
Two. He makes the shot.
You can't hold him any more than that.
On the dribble, gives it up. He makes the block. That one finds its way out of bounds, but we'll keep it right here. Setting up here in their Princeton offense.
I'll tell you, their stuff is absolutely dynamic. It is unbelievable the way they get those back cuts. They read so well the defense, and as soon as the defense doesn't see ball, you man, they got a layup.
The Wildcats did a great job of going through the high post on that play.
Well, they manufactured that basket through the high post. I guarantee you that they work on it every day in practice. Double team now, Matt Angle.
Gave it up.
There's the trap.
So much for court awareness. He dribbled out of bounds. Boy, assist to turnover ratios are big, and that's a big turnover.
I'll tell you, they're turning the ball over too often. You can't win when you do that.
Looks like they're setting up into their zone motion on the left side.
Excellent jump shot right there.
And there's sort of a snapshot of our game tempo.
A little half-court action and a little fast breaking, Brad. As a result, we have a balanced tempo reading.
Looking for a good shot. Jumper. Bust the J. The The Blue Jays now running a zone offense.
Well, the key in a zone motion offense is you got to get good ball movement. If you get good ball movement to get the zone, to really slide and use the skip pass to make it tough for that zone to adjust.
On the dribble, gives it up. Now with about 10 seconds to shoot. Brown is spent right now emotionally, Dick.
Hey, he may need some encouragement from one of his teammates.
The Wildcats can't afford to have him pick up too many more fouls. Well, he commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a burst of foul. I like his mentality. No easy baskets.
The Blue Jays will step to the line for the first time. Gets the first. Two at the charity stripe. That trap could spell some trouble. Running that Princeton offense here.
Well, the Princeton is a unique.
Had his shot blocked. Puts it on the floor and up and under. He's taking a lot of bad shots out there, Dick.
I know, he's trying to catch fire, Brad, but it's just not there.
Tries for two. He gets the shot to fall. What a pass on the backdoor cut.
They got caught sleeping. Great execution, great timing, a beautiful backdoor pass.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. The crowd continues to chant.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage?
The small forward takes the feed. Around 8 minutes remaining on the game clock. He attempts the three. Jumper won't go. Nice shot. Takes it strong to the hoop.
I tell you, you know I like the way this kid uses his body, Brad. He's the type of guy you want in your roster. When you want that inside presence, his size and power is an asset.
Puts it on the floor and up and under. Missed the jumper. Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
The Wildcats. Coaching staff would like for the team to slow it down. He's been pretty animated on the sideline, pleading with his guys to slow it down. It doesn't seem like an up-tempo game is what they're after at this point.
Erin Andrews, our sideline correspondent, as usual, providing that extra bit of insight. Law handles the feed. Man, Dick, they are making scoring here look impossible.
These guys have hit rock bottom. Their confidence at the moment could be any lower.
On the right side. For the bucket. The missed shot. Moving it around the perimeter. Ten to shoot. Puts up the tray. They're having an extremely tough time from the field here today, Dick.
Confidence has got to be an issue now, Brad. They aren't shooting the ball with any confidence whatsoever. It's Brick City, USA.
Unloads a three. Knocks it down. We're at the six-minute mark. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. He goes up with it. Off the mark.
I tell you, they all want to take it to the rack. High wire rack, baby. Little dipsy-doo dunkaroo.
Controlling the ball. Way out on the right wing. He shoots from the corner. They got it. That was a nice play, Dick.
They got into one of the most valuable parts of the court, Mr. Nessler. The high post is a gold mine if you can make the right decisions with the ball.
Gave it up. Goes up for two. Goes in. Nice look on that backdoor pass, Dick.
Great recognition by both players. The backdoor cut is one of those types of plays you love to see.
5 minutes left in the game clock. On the wing. He pulls up with a jumper. Gets the J to fall. Now they work it around the perimeter.
Steal, go up the other way, get a layup.
The Blue Jays looking to attack in transition. Number 15 receives the ball. That is a dagger in the heart, that shot, Dick.
Hey, they lost focus here. They need a timeout to regroup, Brad.
Cross court. Three. Nails the jumper. We're at the 4 minute mark. They'll work it around the arc. Tries one from 3 point land. And come up short. Looking for a good shot. He tries the jumper. He's just not seeing the floor, Dick.
He doesn't want to, Brad. He wants to score, and I'll tell you, that ain't good for team morale, baby.
On the right side. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Down inside. He shoots from the deep corner. He misses the fadeaway. 3 minutes left in the game clock. Working it around the perimeter. Tries a three. 10 seconds.
Inside.
Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us. Erin?
Well, it's quite obvious that the coaching staff wants their team to slow down the tempo. I can hear him on the sideline talking to his bench players about being patient and running sets. He wants the defense to break down first before settling for a shot. Unless, of course, it's a layup. Guys?
Erin Andrews, always close to the action. They work the perimeter. We're at the 2 minute mark. And it's heading out of bounds. No, great save. Can't get the shot to go. For two, off the mark with that shot. Had a momentary look from 3 point land. He shoots from left of the circle and off the mark. Law handles the pass with the J. You can't go those kind of stretches against a team of this quality and expect to win. On the outside. There's a slam. About a minute remaining in the game clock. Launches the three. He has taken his team completely out of this game.
These young guys have to remember to let the game come to you. Don't force the action.
Missed it. And we've got a change in possession here. Foster is making his presence felt on the court so far.
He's been playing like he has one thing on his mind, winning. He's been doing whatever it takes to get baskets and stops. We'll have to wait and see if that translates into a win here today.
And now setting up here in their Princeton offense.
Hey, Brad, the Princeton offense is based on a lot of motion, movement without the basketball. You got to really be able to cut and go to the goal.
They work it around the perimeter. Jumper. Nails a sweet jumper. Shot clock is dead. On the dribble, gives it up. Here they go in transition. Offensively, they get into their zone motion. At the horn. Off the glass and no good. At halftime, the Wildcats are down by 8. Northwestern is known for their accurate field goal shooting, though it was anything but that in the first half.
Hey, perhaps the whole team caught the cold shooting bug. They better find a cure right away at halftime, or it's going to be a long, long night.
Makes his way back into the ballgame. You think it's a good move, Dick?
Yeah, it's a move you've got to make, Brad. This guy holds this club together.
Foster receives the ball on the outside. He wants a three. He takes another bad shot.
Bad shots kill chemistry, Brad. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important on how talented gloves like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
The Wildcats. Coaching staff was concerned at halftime because of the team's poor showing at the offensive end. They're a team who likes to play a slow, deliberate style and also take good shots. They've gotten away from this and are suffering because of it. Look for improvement in the second half. Guys?
Thanks, Erin. On the inside, tries for two. Oh, yes. From way outside, jumper won't go.
Good second half effort, though. Great rebound.
Trying to feed inside.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
The turn, a fadeaway jumper.
I tell you, uses the ball really well, too, in terms of putting it to the deck, turns, spins. He's got every move in the book.
Dumps it in. Takes his jumper.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Cross court from three-point range. Scorches the net with a J. The Bloejays will play up-tempo at one end and in the half court at the other end. Wouldn't you agree, Dick?
Brad, they like to balance the attack. They don't feel like they can always play up-tempo or always play in the half court. Therefore, they mix it up and do a little bit of both. I think this style works for them.
Gave it up. Here's a double team. Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nessler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots. I can't emphasize it enough, Brad. It's important to get to the charity stripe.
You can't miss free throws, Dick. It's going to kill you somewhere down the line.
Well, you got to convert. That's the one thing, like football, special situations. You got to be able to execute there.
Good. Traps in place, Dick. And it's knocked loose. He steals it.
Put him off guard there.
The Bloejays are going into their zone motion offense now. They work it around the perimeter. For the bucket. He gets the bucket to fall. Goes up for two. He shows the sweet touch.
Look at that spacing.
For two. Knocks it down. Nice look on that backdoor pass, Dick.
I tell you, that was a great backdoor play. Terrific execution right there. The defense stopped concentrating for a second, and they got beat backdoor.
Number 44 picks up the foul. Fourth personal foul. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled him to prevent the easy basket.
When he gets to the line, he's usually making them.
He really knows how to focus in on the target during free throws.
And he doesn't miss that opportunity either. The man might be in a little bit of trouble here, Dick. And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
Well, you know, the key to this offense, you better have a big guy on the inside who can be effective, and then a big guy who has versatility who can step out. And they certainly have the elements to make this offense work.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Knocks it down. He puts up the three ball. Can't connect. On the dribble, gives it up.
Great pressure, great double team. Really explosive.
Throws it up. Tries for two. Foster receives the ball.
Nope.
And the ball's out of bounds. We'll go back the other way. The Bloejays have come out here, and they're really focused on sharing the ball and really playing pretty good defense.
You know, everyone's been getting involved. Passing, rebounding, taking the ball through the hoop. A great team effort will always keep a team in it.
Running that Princeton offense here.
I tell you, look at the movement they're getting. Great backdoor cuts, tremendous use of the high post, great execution to the weak side.
In the post, puts it on the floor and up and under. Off the mark. Looking for a good shot. For the bucket, it sticks. Looks like they're setting up into their zone motion. Gave it up. He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot. Off the mark. Looking to move it around the perimeter. takes the jumper. It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
I'm sorry, Brad, but this young fella seems to be their only hope at the moment.
On the left side.
Pressure that basketball, help one another, communicate.
Puts it on the floor and up and under.
Had that great job of the ball fake that created the up and under move. And good footwork, it's essential with an up and under move to utilize good footwork.
Moving it around the perimeter. Goes up for two. That was nice. They've got a three-point shooter spotting up. Arm and foul. Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits a foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
Turner is usually automatic when he steps to the line.
He really knows how to focus in on the target during free throws.
He hits his second. They're shooting extremely well from the stripe tonight, Dick.
Yeah, they're making their coaches look good for making them shoot extra free throws every day.
Now let's check back in now on our Star Watch player. The Bloejays are going into their zone motion offense now. Isolated on the outside, they're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Puts up the J, busts the jumper. Cross court. He attempts the jump shot.
Excellent jump shot right there.
The perimeter from right in the circle, and he missed. He gets the bucket. Cross court. Number 25 is whistled for the foul. First personal foul. Well, he commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy baskets.
Everyone on this squad's pretty solid from the free throw line. Their team free throw percentage is pretty good.
I don't know exactly what it is, but these guys take great pride in their free throw shooting.
Misses the second shot. On the dribble, gives it up. Goes up. Jumper won't go. They'll work it around the arc. And we're at the 8-minute mark. Now with 10 to shoot. For two, that one's off. As we continue to track the game's tempo.
A little half-court action, a little fast breaking, Brad. As a result, we have a balanced tempo reading.
No good. Long receives the ball. Cross court. There's the rejection. Great hustle. And a slam. Gave it up. About 7 minutes remaining.
Terrific block shot, though. He's a dominator blocking shots on the interior.
The Wildcats are going to have to switch some things up here, Mr. Vitale. When you consider time and score, I think it's time for them to ditch the half-court style and get some easy baskets.
Playing in the full court usually isn't their thing, but they're going to have to play in this manner in order to get back into the game.
The Bloejays are going to probably switch up their style here and play mainly in the half court, especially now since they've got the lead.
Hey, with the lead, they have to really focus on defense and defensive stops. The goal now should be to run sets and keep the clock from stopping.
From beyond the arc, nails a sweet jumper. Let's get back to the action. And now setting up here in their Princeton offense.
I'll tell you, their stuff is absolutely dynamic. It is unbelievable the way they get those back cuts. They read so well the defense, and as soon as the defense doesn't see ball, you man, they got a layup.
So the pass will come in from the baseline. Out of bounds, and we're staying right here. So inbound on the baseline. Running that Princeton offense here.
I'll tell you, Brad, that Princeton offense utilizes the high post exceptionally well. You cut off that high post, you get great motion, you make sure you have movement. The key to any offense is movement without the basketball. If you got movement without the basketball, you're gonna get good shots.
He puts up the tray and come up short. Long handles the feed. The Wildcats are going into their zone motion offense now. On the dribble, gives it up. He shoots the jumper. Nails the jumper. Looking for a good shot. Tries for two. Lays it up. About 5 minutes remaining in the game clock. On the left side. Gets it to fall. This guy can really score in a variety of ways down on the low block.
I tell you, Brad, he can beat you face up, or he can beat you with his back to the basket. He can step a few feet out, and he's been able to convert. He's a tough, tough matchup.
Working it around the perimeter. He looks for three. Can't connect.
Inside
for the bucket. The layup is good. They are running right through this defense.
The bombs are bursting, baby.
They work the perimeter.
Turnover by the senior.
About 4 minutes remaining. He shoots from the deep corner for two.
What a terrific play to tip that ball back. The awareness, the basketball IQ.
And had a momentary look from three-point land. Goes up for two. Two with a lay-in. On the outside. There's a double team waiting there. He makes the jumper. About 3 minutes remaining. They work it around the perimeter. He shoots from the elbow. He misses the chain. On the left side. On the outside. For the deuce. With the layup. He cut back door and received the pass.
It's great seeing those types of plays. That's team basketball. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards up there.
Yeah, it helps. It looks as though the students are all wound up and ready to agitate the opposition.
Isn't it great, Brad?
Out on the left wing. For the bucket. Not there. About 2 minutes remaining on the game clock.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He attempts the three. He doesn't get the hoop. With a layup. The perimeter. He goes for three. The missed shot. He just flicked it in.
Look at that spacing.
Tries for two. Too strong. About a minute remaining for two. Off target. The small forward gets the pass. He looks for three. He misses the jumper. Let's see if they can get a good shot this trip. On the left side. Three-pointer. He knocks down the jumper. Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
His shot blocked from behind.
He set him up nicely. Better foul quick.
Well, it's time to start fouling. They got to stop the clock, Dick. Let's check out this three-pointer one more time, Dick. Coming from the sideline. And now setting up here in their Princeton offense.
Hey, it's a great system if all five guys are on the same page. It really forces you to work on defense. 50% of the time, it leaves the defense looking silly.
He goes to the line for the first time. He makes the front end of the one and one. The second. We've got a break in the action, folks. Stay tuned for more ESPN coverage of the NCAA. Timeout's called. Let's check in with Aaron Andrews.
Based on the score and the time remaining, the coaches will be looking to calm their players down. Adrenaline levels may have shot up over the last few possession, guys, so the coach will be looking to reduce any anxiety. It should make for an interesting finish. Back up to you.
What mindset, Dick, do coaches want their players to have when they leave a timeout?
Well, for me, Brad, I wanted my players to have a clear understanding of what the objectives were for the upcoming possessions. Timeouts are a great way to get your team back on track and a way to really alter the tempo of the game. Great coaches have a knack for calling timeouts at the right times.
Welcome back, and we're set to inbound after the timeout. Pushes it up. He shoots from downtown. Nope. Number 44 is called for the foul. As we take a look at the sophomore.
Well, Brad, he's still mature. With your underclassmen, it's about improvement day by day, year after year.
It'll be interesting to see who responds how out of the timeout, Brad.
Jumper! He misses it. Blocks the shot. Gave it up.
A lot of pressure on a basketball. Way to play the ball. Tough. Drive him, beat him, turn him, beat him to his spot.
Coaches love it when their team gets to the free throw line. It's an opportunity to put points on the board and potentially get the opponent in foul trouble.
He makes his second shot. And after the timeout, we're all set to pick things up. He looks for the bomb. No good from the field. Northwestern was caught in quite a battle tonight before pulling ahead for good.
The team has got to feel good about a win like this.
It's been a fun game, and as always, my partners alongside have enjoyed you being with us. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler. Good night, everybody.